Hello, and we meet again, and I want to tackle a great question we got in from a community member for today's webinar. It was, my daughter's been tracking her food for the last several weeks, and now she wants to know, what should she do with this information, right? She's new to tracking, she's got several weeks in her food log. What do I do with all this information, Heather? I mean, really? So let me just say, you have a treasure trove of content, of information in that food log to begin to observe. So, some high level things. First, I want to say, let me add this caveat. Whatever you are willing to change has to be things you're going to be okay with doing for the long term. So that's number one. So let's just assume you've got a couple weeks of food logs to go through. The very first thing I would do is get the average calorie content for the last couple weeks. I would compare it to my body weight and see if it's actually kind of maintaining in that range. Then I would know, okay, if long-term my goal is weight loss, I know I need to drop my calorie some. But it's not just that cut and dry. What you want to do is go back up to the top part of the food log and take a look at where your biggest calorie consumptions are happening. Maybe it's certain meals. Maybe it's through snacks in the day, maybe it's sugary drinks, maybe it's from eating out. And I would start to ask myself really important questions like, if my goal is weight loss and I want to drop my daily calories by 300 or 400 or whatever, what is it I'm willing to start to cut out of my diet to produce that calorie deficit? Some other very important things you want to be looking for is, are you being consistent with your meals? Meaning, are you eating a consistent breakfast, lunch, and dinner? Are there certain days during the week that you're not, and then you're noticing your eating at in the evening becomes more erratic or high calorie? You know, you may also start to notice that your protein content isn't evenly distributed through the day. So, I mean, my word, I mean, we could go on and on and on. I mean, are you eating more snack calories than you are eating actual meal calories? That would be another one. How much of your day is going to treats and snacks versus how much of it's going to substantial food that's going to sustain you, right? How many servings of vegetables and fruits are you having? That's something else you can pull from there. How many times in a week are you eating out? And is that maybe causing some of the problems? Because again, if you've read The Diet Fix by Dr. Yanni Friedhoff, you know that on average, restaurants are off by at least 20% on their calorie predictions. So what you want to do is think to yourself, what are my goals? Number one. Number two, let me see what I can initially pull. How many fruits and vegetable servings? How much protein am I consuming? Is the protein evenly distributed? How many calories am I devoting to snacks and treats? Is that working for me? If I have to create a calorie deficit out of all the foods that I'm eating through the day, what would I be willing to trim out? If I find I'm eating out 3 or 4 times a week, am I gonna start being willing to let go of some of those and maybe make homemade meals, right? It's just so much good content. Alcohol. How many alcoholic beverages are you having in a given day or week? Are you willing to modify that, right? So this is like, this is the goal. This is like the gold treasure chest of why it is you are where you are. If you want to change, it's going to come from that food journal where you are documenting day in and day out what you're honestly eating, not what you want everyone to think you're doing, not what you want to pretend, not the half filled out food log. I'm talking about you really want to make change. You're willing to be really honest with yourself. You're saying, this is my current reality and I want to improve from here. So that food log is going to give you everything you need to know. And then from there, you just start making small modifications. If you want to, a great place to do to begin with this, by the way, is the Breaking the Diet Cycle course. That course will help you go through that information. It will help you start to figure out how to create goals, how to start to create habits to change based on that. But that is how you want to use your food log. Every single food item you're putting in your mouth on a routine basis is supporting you being the weight you are. And if you want to start to change the body weight, You must begin to change how you consume foods and the habits you have around foods. And the only way you will actually know your reality is if you're willing to honestly journal them in your food log. You have a great day. Let me know below how you are starting to assess your food log honestly and what things you are noticing are becoming patterns or behaviors that you think you might change long term. All right, take care. Bye.